Welcome back to Sunday Morning Quickies, episode 68 for the 15th of January, 2023. Yeah, I know it's not Sunday morning anymore. It's actually 20 minutes to 2 in the afternoon on Sunday. But what I needed for this video didn't arrive until yesterday afternoon, until Saturday afternoon, just before Liz and I were leaving to go to a Christmas party. And if you're wondering why we were going to a Christmas party on the 14th of January, it's a long story. We won't get into it, but it's a tradition with a group of friends. Anyway, today's Sunday morning afternoon quickie is it's a combination of a tool tip, a thank you to a viewer, and a little bit of show and tell. So it's a little bit late for me for coffee anyway, so grab a beverage of some variety. Can even be an adult beverage, it's well past noon, and kick back and enjoy. Okay, so today I want to talk about work holding. Specifically, in this case, I want to talk about fastener holding. Now, longtime viewers have seen me use these claw-type grippers. These things are used a lot in the jewelry trade for holding gemstones. I have some that have five prongs, like this one. More commonly available now are these four-prong ones. And I have used them to grip the head of a screw and get it in position to insert it into the machines. Now that works well and good in many cases. In some cases it doesn't. A lot of times, and a lot of times you don't see it because I edit it out because it's several attempts, that will happen. And that always happens. Like, I'll start it out like this and all of a sudden, boom, it's like that. And you don't see it because I edit that out, because I turn around and change it, and I edit out the profanities that go with that. Well, viewer Harlan had sent me an email a while back asking if I'd be interested in some screw holders. And I'm like, sure, I'm always interested in interesting tools. So he sent me these. Now, these are made by the HJJ Company of Los Gatos, California, which I have tried to find them online. They appear to be defunct. Now, these screw holders work kind of interestingly. Let me see if you can if I can focus on this. You see, it's kind of like a split thing here, and it's in a brass tube. So what happens is you put that into the head of the screw, and then you push, and as you push that in, it expands. So here, I'll just show it without actually putting it in there. You see, you push, that expands, and that grips the screw. We'll demonstrate that again. Put it in, push a little bit, and it expands. Now, this is a game changer, for me anyway, because that means you're no longer going to be seeing the back of my hand as I struggle to get screws in. All well and good. These are great. Well, I went, and I can't thank Harlan enough. So I went on the internet saying, I want to find more of these. Well, apparently the HJ, and Harlan got these back in, I believe it was the late 1960s, when he was doing typewriter repair. So, anyway, I went online. I found plenty of references to the HJJ company, no longer in Los Gatos, California. They appeared to be in Nevada at that point, but now they also appear to be defunct. So, not to be forsaken, I went to McMaster Carr, and I found this style of screw starter. Now, these are kind of cool. You'll see they are bolt action and spring loaded. And if you look at the business end, I'm hoping you can see that, there's a blade that is at an angle to the fixed blades, and when you cock it, the interior blade is retracted a little bit and in line. So when you put this on a fastener and then release that, that part that was at rest when it was cocked, now it's not quite at rest. You'll see it's partially through the bolt action, but that twists sideways and that holds the fastener quite firmly. This too will allow getting in there and starting the screw. Once the screw starts, just pull it off, bada bing, bada boom. My big meat hooks aren't in the way. So this was a set of four. There's two that work for Phillips and two that work for standard slotted screws. They also make, not included in the kit, but they also make one that works on Torx and Phillips square drive. And there's also one that handles both slotted and Phillips. So there's a variety of these available. And another cool thing is they have magnets on the back end. So if you drop something, you can pick them up. Nice. I'll have links to this stuff down below. I will also add these to my list of cool tools. But not to be resting on that. Also on McMaster's page, they had these, and I bought a bunch of them. Actually, I bought five different sizes, different styles. I'm going to show you how these, the magnets, how these work using this larger one. All right, now you see the end of this is split and it's in line. And it has this little device here, which as you push it down the shaft of the screwdriver, what happens, watch the end. Those two split portions, there are wedges, and they get tighter on the fastener. So if you put that on thusly and you squeeze it, the wedges tighten up on the fastener, holding the screw, whatever position, get it started. So once again, these awesomeness, and I've got them in multiple sizes. I've got five different ones here. The magnets on those are being a pain in the neck at the moment. The littlest one here is actually quite tiny. And you can see it does the same kind of action. Let me pull another fastener out here. Actually, they're all going to work about the same. I'll put the smaller screw in. This is just out of my parts bins. Smaller screw in. Slide that down. Grippy, grippy, grip. These are going to be awesome. They weren't super expensive. Of these, they're averaging like $8, $9 a piece, something like that. This set of these was 30-ish something. So yeah, these are going to be a huge part, as well as the ones that Harlan sent. These are going to be a huge part of what's going on in the shop from here on out. This one I really, really like. It's for smaller size screws, and it's got a lot of reach to it. So I'm anticipating that this is going to be great for, let's try it out on one. Here is a needle plate screw. Oh yes. Look at that. Right in, bada bing, bada boom. Straight down, getting that in there. Plenty of clearance. Now you don't drive the screws with these, you just start them. You still need to have your regular screwdrivers, be it like the Chapman's or whatever, for tightening. But to get them started, which is 99% of the problem a lot of the times, or at least in my aspect here of trying to keep my big meat hooks out of the camera shot. So this is going to be a game changer. Not necessarily a game changer for repair, but a game changer for my videos. So you won't be staring at the flaming arrow tattoo in the back of my right hand or my left hand just completely obscuring something. This should be a huge help, especially working in and around like in the needle bar box, or even putting... Actually, for reassembly, these are going to be great for doing on 66 class machines, doing the feed dog screw. Getting in there just for access. So that's what I got for you today. This is a short Sunday morning quickie, but I thought you guys would enjoy seeing these and appreciate the power of screw holding. So, well, there you have it. That's what I've got for you this week. Incidentally, the lovely and talented Elizabeth, she was really, really excited when these screw holding screw starters arrived yesterday. She comes running into the shop to check them out real quick. And she is anticipating using them as well on her side of the shop, too. So, anyway, that's what we got for you this week. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.